Your Samsung Galaxy S21 5G has a broken display, or the touch doesn't work properly anymore? In this repair video, we show you how you can easily replace your display yourself. Replacing the display of the S21 is relatively easy. For the first time, Samsung has already integrated a new battery into the replacement display. This eliminates the need to remove the heavily glued battery. Plan about 45 to 60 minutes for the repair. For the repair of the Galaxy S21 5G, you need the following tools. In addition, these tools can be helpful. All tools and an original Samsung replacement display can be found in our online store at iDoc.eu. You can find the links in the video description. If you get stuck at any point, feel free to post your question in the comments. Our support team is always happy to help. Switch off your Galaxy S21 5G to avoid potential short circuits during the repair. The smartphone is opened via the heavily glued plastic back cover. Please note that your phone is no longer 100% waterproof after opening it. To open it, you first have to heat the adhesive frame of the back cover. We use a heat gun for this, but a normal hairdryer also works fine. Run the hot air gun evenly over the edge of the back cover for a few minutes. Heat especially the part where you want to start opening. Once the back cover is sufficiently heated, use a flat, sturdy tool to remove it piece by piece from the case unit. We can recommend the iFlex for this purpose. It is made of flexible, very flat metal and has sharp edges that are particularly easy to insert. Attach a suction cup to the lower edge of the back cover and pull it upwards to create a narrow gap. Be careful not to burn your fingers on the heated back cover. Then, carefully insert the iFlex between the back cover and the case frame. Do not insert it too deeply so as not to damage anything inside the device. Since you can quickly scratch something with the sharp edges of the iFlex, we recommend switching to a plastic tool like the iPlastics as soon as possible. Run the tool along the edge of the back cover and detach it piece by piece from the rest of the case. Put flat plastic picks on the loosened areas so that the glue cannot bond again. Heat the edge from time to time and work your way forward. Be especially careful on the sensitive camera module. We recommend that you work with a hard plastic pick at this point, as its shape ensures that it cannot be inserted too deeply. The back cover is glued around the flashlight as well, so you should heat again there. Once the back cover is completely detached, you can remove all flat picks and take it off. On the inner side of the back cover, you can now see the adhesive frame that we heated up and loosened. As mentioned, it is glued separately around the flashlight. Put the back cover aside. Then take a Phillips screwdriver and a screw storage, such as a magnetic pad, to loosen the screws of the NFC antenna and store them safely. The NFC antenna contains the coil for wireless charging. Its metal cover protects the motherboard. Carefully fold the cover upwards. Underneath it, the orange connector of the battery and the black connector of the NFC antenna are located directly next to each other. Separate both connectors by carefully levering them off the motherboard with a plastic spatula. To avoid short circuits during the repair, you should separate the battery connector first. Small parts on the motherboard can easily be damaged, so make sure you lever from a free side if possible. Once the connectors are separated, you can remove the NFC antenna. The lower end is glued. On the bottom of the antenna, you can easily see the connector that you have separated. Now remove the earpiece. To do so, unscrew the 7 Phillips screws. Then separate the earpiece connector and take it out of the device. To remove the motherboard, you first have to separate all connectors that are attached to it. The connectors belong to the two 5G antennas, the display cable, the two connecting cables, and the front camera. Unscrew the single Phillips screw from the camera module. Now you can pry the motherboard out of its guard with a spatula and carefully pull it out from under the loosened connectors. To remove the speaker, first loosen its six Phillips screws. Then you can lever it out of the screen unit. In the upper left corner, a small arrow marks a recess where you can place your tool. Separate the two connecting cables by carefully prying the connectors off the USB board. Then, put them aside and turn your attention to the screen cable. With the S21, the screen cable is not enclosed in the screen unit for the first time. Thanks to a separate slot, it can be completely removed and thus also be replaced if necessary. You will need a pointed tool to remove the SIM tray as easily as possible. We use a special SIM tool for this purpose. Press the tool into the small opening on the SIM tray and pull it out of the device frame. The USB board has to be removed as well. First, unscrew the three Phillips screws for this. Then carefully lift the board upwards and pull it out of the device's frame. You can find an original Samsung replacement screen and tools for this repair in our online store at iDoc.eu. Check it out! In the original Samsung replacement screen, several components are already pre-assembled. For example, the vibration motor, the front camera, two 5G antennas, and the battery. This simplifies the display repair considerably. Remove the protective film of the battery. The protective film on the screen glass can be left on until the very end of the repair. At this point, you can reinstall all removed components into your replacement screen. Start with the USB board. You have to push the USB connector into the edge of the case to make sure it sits evenly. Then screw the board back in place with the three Phillips screws. Push the SIM tray back into the case frame so that it snaps in perceptibly. Position the screen cable over the battery again and attach the lower connector. It should audibly and perceptibly click into place. Be especially careful when attaching connectors and never use force to tighten them. Damage can lead to the failure of an entire component. Also reattach the two connecting cables on the USB board. The labeling on the cables will help you to align them correctly. Now insert the speaker. It has three small lugs. You have to hook them into the screen unit's frame to make it sit level. Afterwards, you can screw the speaker back in place. To avoid jamming or damaging the connectors when inserting the motherboard, you should hold them away with tweezers. Check again that the board sits level and that all connectors lie above the board before you screw the camera module back in place. Then carefully press all six connectors back onto the motherboard. Position the earpiece over the motherboard again and screw it in place. Then, press down its connector. Now attach the NFC antenna again. Press the lower sticky end of the module back on and remember to reattach both the antenna and the battery connector. The battery connector last. Finally, screw the metal cover back on. Before you finally close your S21, we recommend that you first test the replacement screen. Switch on your device first. Then call up the Samsung test menu via *#0*#, and check whether the color display and the touch function correctly. Our checklist can give you a good orientation for testing. We'll link it to you in the info box. You can then test other basic functions, such as the speaker. This way, you can be sure that your repair was successful. If something does not work properly, check again if all components are attached and screwed correctly. Align the back cover over the screen unit and press it firmly along the frame, so that it sits evenly everywhere. To ensure that the adhesive bonds properly, you should heat the edge of the back cover for a few minutes and then weigh it down with a couple of books or press it together with the help of clips, as in our example. I hope the display of your Galaxy S21 5G is now restored to its full splendor. If this tutorial has helped you, then give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to never miss any of our tutorials and videos about smartphones. High-quality tools, spare parts, and accessories can be found in our online store. iDock, everything for your smartphone. Find more helpful videos here. See you next time!